All right, so you might be wondering why I'm sitting here in this obvious medical chair. It's because after everything I've been through, 9 surgeries, over 10,000 grafts over the past 20 some odd years, Propecia, a little bit of Rogaine, and knowing about every treatment out there, I'm finally sitting down and having PRP with this guy, Dr. Jerry Cooley. And this is Ailene. Say hi. Yeah. Real quick, Dr. Cooley, tell us, what is PRP and how are we doing this?
So the way we're going to do it is we're going to draw 120 cc's of blood from your arm. That's about a quarter of what you would go and donate when you donate blood. We're going to run it through our machine, which will centrifuge it and separate it into red blood cells, plasma, and in between we get the platelet-rich plasma.
Okay.
So we're going to get about 8 cc's of PRP, and we're going to mix it with A-cell.
Okay.
And that's a mix of growth factors. The PRP is sort of suspended in liquid.
Mm-hmm.
The A cell is a powder, and it acts more of a timed release. So the PRP works very quickly.
Okay.
The A cell acts over the course of many days, so they complement each other nicely.
Okay.
We're going to inject that into your crown to thicken up the miniaturizing hair.
Okay.
Now, the degree of improvement will vary from person to person. It might be a little bit of thickening. We might get above average thickening if we're lucky, or we'll get average thickening.
Okay. All right. Let's do this.
All right. A little pinch.
And one thing I want to stress about PRP treatments, they are not to be considered as a replacement for more conventional treatments like Propecia, even Rogaine, things like that. And they're certainly not to be taken as replacements for surgery. Now, they can be used for some patients to stave off surgery, and those patients will be the ones that have a lot of miniaturization, such as diffused hair loss patients. If you're a full-blown Norwood 6, it's not going to do much for you. But unless you have those areas of your pattern that have continued miniaturization, like on the fringe, that'd be right.
Right.
Yeah.
The people I reckon, the more miniaturized hair you have, the more you're going to benefit.
Yeah.
So if you take, say, a 3A who's just got, say, a band of miniaturization, normally I wouldn't recommend it being worth the money.
Right.
But you'll see patterns, you know, there's what we call diffuse patterned alopecia, which we actually see a fair amount of, where someone has, from a distance, it may look like a 3 or 4, but in fact, when you get through that
like a 6
zone of hair,
it's
actually very miniaturized.
Yeah.
And then, of course, a lot of the women we see have extensive miniaturization.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay, so now we're loading it in the centrifuge. We're in the lab of Dr. Cooley's clinic. So this is a full kit.
Yes.
So it comes.
It's never exposed to the outside air.
Right.
So it's sterile throughout the entire process.
Okay. So that's where the separate components come in.
Right.
As it's being spun, okay. And you were telling me when I was here before that you've been through a few different centrifuges to find.
There's another one right here.
Yeah, I saw that one, yeah, to find the one that you felt was best for PRP, and you settled on this one.
Right.
Yeah.
All of the machines on the market have different characteristics. They give you a little different platelet concentration, the proportion of red blood cells, white blood cells. And although there's no consensus, most people think that the higher concentration is better of platelets. So this produces 5 times your baseline,
okay,
which means if we sent your blood to the lab, we'd get a platelet count, and if we sent the PRP to the lab, it would be five times higher.
Okay.
Some kits out on the market give you barely one or two times your baseline. And it also allows you to reduce the amount of red blood cells that are in the PRP. And the red blood cells, if there are too many of them, create a lot of inflammation, which is not good.
Okay. So you gotta have a good balance.
So we can program in different settings on the screen. Check, everything's good. And we're off.
Yeah, there's my blood. There it goes. So this is what it's like to have your blood treated to separate the plasma for a PRP treatment. And then at some point it reverses and goes back through these tubes into these separate bags. So now the centrifuge process is slowing down, and you can look in the center, and now there's a separation that's happened. I've got there's the plasma. Now it actually separates into specific bags. So much things going on here. Okay, here comes something else. Oh, there we go. Shows the bag being filled. Okay, so here we are again. My blood has been spun or centrifuged, and we're here with Brandy. Say hi, Brandy.
Hi.
And she's going to stick needles in my head. I think she's been looking forward to this. I don't know. Yeah, it's completely numb.
Tell me if you feel anything. You feel that at all?
Nope.
So I'm really focusing on the border because
that's where any fringe mitras hairs would be.
Is non-graft on the top of your head. So after we put in the PRP, we put in calcium thrombin with a little bit of a microneedling motion to activate the platelets and get them to release their growth factors. If you don't do that, they may or may not do what we want them to do. They just sit there until they get washed away.
And this just kind of triggers the activity.
This activates it, is what we say.
Yeah.
Activates the PRP. Now I'm just kind of microneedling over just to activate the surface as well as even out the
distribution.
The distribution. Yeah. The scout.